Hello, my name is Sameer Singh and I'm a technical marketing engineer in the NetSec team at Cisco. This is a new video to ease your journey using the firewall migration tool. In this video, we will take a brief look at the different new features introduced in FMD 5.0.1 version. With the new version, now users will be able to migrate transparent mode security context also from AAC to FTD, along with the routed mode security contexts. The transparent mode includes the migration of the VBI interfaces associated with the bridge groups containing interfaces that the ASA bridges. After uploading the configuration, the tool will provide the user with the option of selecting one from the list of identified contexts. The user will be able to migrate a single transparent mode security context one at a time, as well as merge two or more transparent mode contexts in ASA to a transparent mode instance and migrate it to FTD. The new version is also changed in the way that it no longer asks for a primary context when the option selected is merge context, but provides the user with a list of contexts for the user to select that needs to be merged and migrated. The user can select two or more routed or transparent firewall mode contexts to merge and perform the migration, but the selected context should be of the same type, either routed or transparent. When merging two or more contexts having VPN configurations, VPN configuration from only one context will be migrated, and the tool provides the option to the user to select which context migration configuration will be migrated. VPN configuration from other contexts are ignored. We also have the option on the mapping interface page to enter the name of the VRFs for the interfaces, as well as select the option to auto-create security zones, interface groups, and VRF names for routed context migration. Now let's take a look at some of the use cases of objects with conflict when migrating different contexts and how the tool handles it. If there are conflicting interface names, the names are updated in the contexts following the naming convention. If there is a network object NAT that is in one context and an object with the same name but in a different context has a different value in another, the tool renames the objects before merging. If there are network object NAT rules in different contexts with the same interface name and same object name, the tool renames the objects and interfaces, ensuring the objects are mapped correctly with the NAT rule. AS path objects must be unique across all contexts. And if an existing object with same name is found on FMC, the tool gives a warning message to resolve the conflict. Prefix list objects are added with a sequence number beginning from 5 and incrementing in 5. And if there is any name conflict between objects across different contexts, the defining naming convention is used to differentiate the objects. Same logic holds for community list objects, standard access list, policy lists, and route maps. This version supports migration of Fortinet Remote Access VPN configuration to FTD. The FMC must be 7.2 or above, and FTD should be 7.0 or above. The trust points should be manually migrated to FMC as PKI objects, and any client images should be uploaded to FMC as part of the pre-migration activity. Supported migrations are SSL VPN deployed in tunnel mode and IPsec RMVPN configured in Ike V2 mode. Supported authentication methods include SAML, LDAP, RADIUS, and local authentication. Next, we have site-to-site VPN configuration migration from Fortinet to FTD, for which the target FMC and FTD should be 6.6 or above. For policy-based VPN and 6.7 or above for route-based VPN. and the Fortinet firewall with the source configuration should be version 5 and above. The trust points need to be manually migrated as PKI objects on FMC, and the tool migrates the tunnels as point-to-point network topology. The tool now also supports Palo Alto Firewall RAVPN configuration to be migrated to FTD as long as the target FMC is 7.2 or above and FTD is 7.0 or above and the Palo Alto Firewall is 8.0 or above. Supported authentication methods include SAML, LDAP, RADIUS and local authentication, and the trust points from PAN need to be migrated manually as PKI objects on FMC. Right now, the CAX and Kerberos authentication is not supported on the tool. For site-to-site VPN migration, from Palo Alto to FTD, the target FMC and FTD version should be 6.7 and above, and the source firewall should be 8.0 or above. The VPN tunnels will be migrated as point-to-point network topology, and the trust points need to be manually migrated to PKI objects on FMC. Let's take a look at some of the additional fixes that are part of the new version of the tool. With FMC version 7.725 and above, all the ECMP static routes configured with same metric and via the same interface can be migrated from ASA to FTD as opposed to only one route in previous versions. In the latest version of the tool, if there are more than 50 security zones associated with the access route, the migration report now mentions the zones that have been ignored in the access rules for reference when user adds them manually. The tool now lists the interfaces in ASA that do not have any ACL attached to them, so the report can be referred to add the required interfaces in the access rule as per requirement. Extended ACL object conflict handling is now supported, reusing the objects with same name and context and asking the user to rename if the content does not match. This brings us to the end of the video covering the new features and fixes introduced in Firewall Migration Tool version 5.0.1. I hope this was useful to you and thank you.